UFO Showtime, a presentation of the United Service Organization in cooperation with the American Forces Vietnam Network.
Forever by the Beatles. Our pen pal letter today is from Lakewood, California. Hi. The best way I know of introducing myself is by telling you about me. So here goes. My name is Sandra Mae Hannon, but I prefer to be called Sandy. My age is 22. My height is 5'10". I like swimming, bowling, roller skating, baseball, and bicycle riding, and volleyball. I like, not love, like watching football, baseball, and roller skating on TV. I have two dogs. One dog is mine. His name is Corky. The other dog is my sister's. His name is Puffy. I live with my stepfather and my mother and my 18-year-old sister and my 4-year-old brother. I love to make chocolate chip cookies, and I send them to my sister's husband, who is in the Army, and all of the guys he shares them with love them. So if you'd like to write to me, maybe I'll be sending you some chocolate chip cookies. Well, that's about it for now, and it's signed Sandy Hannon. So if you'd like to write to Sandy Hannon from Lakewood, California, and she may send you some chocolate chip cookies, why don't you just drop me a line and I'll send her a gift to you. And that's Diana, USA Saigon, APO, in-country, 96243. Okay, and do it today. Here's Apache by The Arrow. It goes out to 65 Kilcrease of the 101st Airborne. Charter flight to the States for 2 weeks, however long it is. World Airways has flights every Thursday through the 30th of December, and the destination is Oakland, San Francisco, and the cost is $350, and there are ticket offices throughout Vietnam, so you have to contact your nearest USO or go to Special Services to see when the ticket sellers come to your area. And TIA, that's Trans International Airlines, has flights on the 18th and 16th of December, and offices are in Da Nang, Longdon, and Saigon, and the cost is $399 to Chicago. So contact your USO for details about these charter flights, okay? Here's a good one about Bob Dylan. It's Lay Lady Lay, and it goes out to Roger Davila of Company E, one of the 327th Infantry, 101st Airborne. Contest, all you have to do is send your girl or wife's name to me and make sure it's her complete address, okay? And just send it to Diana, USA Saigon, APO in country 96243. And departing on November 1st this year for a 35-day tour of Vietnam and Thailand are the new Freeman Singers. And this lively and dynamic group has appeared with the Carpenters and Clara Ward Singers. And they were the first entertainers to perform in Long Beach aboard the Queen Mary. And they will be featured in December in an NBC TV holiday special. And that's a USO show called The New Freeman Singers. And they sound like they're really a together group, okay? So you have to contact your special services officer to find out when the New Freeman Singers will be in your area. Here's beautiful song by Smith. It's called Baby It's You, and it goes out to all the guys at 22nd Replacement Battalion. Guy Smith. Two more shows coming to Vietnam. Well, three more, I guess. Let's see. One is called The Toby Green Show. Three guys and a gal. And it looks like, they're featuring Bonnie B. So it's like a country and western type show. And the Speakeasy Singers, they'll be here for a 30-day tour of Vietnam. They're like a Kingston Trio type group. And, of course, the Capitol Chords Quartet is a group from the Sweet Adelines Incorporated, and it's Barbershop Quartet. Now, the Capitol Chords are from the state of Washington, and they will depart November 15th for a 17-day tour of Vietnam. And let's see what else they have to say about them. Oh, they won all kinds of contests in the East and Kansas in October and everything, so they look like a good group. And that's the Capitol Chords Quartet, the Speakeasy Singers, and the Toby Green Show featuring Bonnie B, all coming to Vietnam very shortly. So you'll have to check with your Special Services officer when they will be in your area. Here's Gene by Oliver, and it goes out to all the guys in Vung Tau, especially Spec 5 Kane. People in China Beach.
Don't it make you wanna?
want to play some tennis or baseball or basketball or golf or any of those things you played when you were at home and you can't get the equipment here, why don't you go to the USA Tonsilitis gift shop and you'll find it all over there, okay? That's USA Tonsilitis gift shop for all your sporting goods. This is Elvis Presley with It's Only Love.
Of the United Service Organization in cooperation with the American Forces Vietnam Network.
Bye and again. Be kind, and I'll talk to you tomorrow. Bye-bye.
American Forces, Vietnam Network.
Aircraft provide quick and efficient transportation almost anywhere in Vietnam. When you travel by air, your pilot is responsible for your safety and well-being. Listen to your pilot, obey the rules, and assure yourself of reaching your destination safely.
News compiled from major commercial and military news sources.
It's 11 o'clock. In the top of the news, President Chu disclosed he's ordered his envoy to meet with the Viet Cong delegation in Paris no later than Tuesday to begin talks on a political solution for South Vietnam. Chu's announcement was coupled with a plea to Vietnam peacekeeping commissions. He wants them to get observers in the field and end the killing of Vietnamese people. Two peacekeeping commissions held long meetings in Saigon yesterday. They tried to get started on the supervision of the ceasefire. President Nixon's State of the Union message contained no specific programs. Those will come later in a series of specific messages to Congress. Yesterday's presidential message was a mixture of philosophy, goals, and a pledge to work with Congress. House Speaker Carl Albert says Congress will consider the president's programs in light of its own constitutional responsibilities. Like other Democrats, Albert apparently expects this Congress to assert its own authority. Senator Harold Hughes says proposed administration budget cuts will be a disaster for millions of Americans. The Iowa Democrat and others on the Labor and Public Welfare Committee asserted this as Caspar Weinberger testified on the budget. Weinberger is President Nixon's nominee for Welfare Secretary. Weinberger says the proposed budget means more spending on health and education. Both areas are under the committee's jurisdiction. But Weinberger maintained that some cuts in some areas are necessary. Some new faces in the cabinet. President Nixon held swearing-in ceremonies for them earlier today, and he pledged his administration to the challenge of peace. Nixon says he now describes the 14 members of his cabinet as a peace cabinet. He says they'll face tasks just as great as those in war. Chief Justice Warren Burger did the swearing-in. President Nixon and British Prime Minister Heath are at Camp David. Their continuing talks started earlier. Heath is on a two-day visit to the United States. Calm has returned to the county jail at Camden, New Jersey. Some 20 prisoners have surrendered peacefully after escaping from their cells and barricading themselves in a prison dorm. Authorities had threatened a tear gas attack. Police Chief Vincent Bono said no one was hurt. Everything's back to normal. During the incident, 1,600 workers were evacuated from the building, which also houses county and city offices. About 100 police and two dozen jail guards cordoned off the building. Then police made their way to the barricaded sixth floor, shouted a warning, and minutes later won the surrender. The Navy confirms the dismissals of some 3,000 of its men on orders from Chief of Naval Operations Admiral Elmo Zumwalt. The 3,000 were said to be a burden to the command. More simply put, troublemakers. Both blacks and whites were involved. Trading was active on Wall Street, but the New York stock market finished lower. The Dow Jones Industrial Average closed down 4.97 at 980.81. The AP 60 stock average finished down 1.1 at 324.5. The National Center for Disease Control reports the London flu that is sweeping the United States has claimed at least 1,027 lives. Reports from major U.S. cities show the number of deaths due to influenza pneumonia has risen above the epidemic threshold for the fourth consecutive week. Flu deaths increased in every region except the Middle Atlantic, South Atlantic, and West Central states. The agency says the death count still is lower than for the same period last year when 1,100 persons died of Hong Kong flu. The government has fined Delta Airlines $2,000. This was for permitting Senator Vance Hartke of Indiana to board an airplane without going through electronic security devices. Hartke had protested the checks. The government says the unemployment rate in January was 5%. That's the lowest in 2.5 years. American and Soviet delegations held talks in Vienna, their meeting to settle the issue of which country should take part in troop reduction discussions. And Dennis the Menace has a sister. She was born in Switzerland to Roland and Hank Ketchen. He's creator of the comic strip first drawn in Monterey, California. It was named for Ketchum's first child, Dennis, who is now 26. That's AFBN News to the Hour. Him and Linda Liston reporting.
News compiled from major commercial and military news sources.